Hello my dear students, this is A.K. Gupta, your English faculty, Arts School Balsam. Now once again welcome back. We are going to start online class. In this class we are going to complete the class 8, the lesson number 1, the best Christmas present in the world, which is written by Michael Morkenberg, and part 3. You know, means we have completed approximately 2 part in this, and now we are going to at next third part. Okay, so in the third part, not according to book, and where I have finished, and thereafter I am going to start. That's the third part. Okay, let's start. So we have finished at last. Now page number 12, I need you, and paragraph number 2. Ah, Dorset. He smiled. He means who? Here is a friend, Hans. You know, Hans Wolf. Hans Wolf, the matter is going on. Hans Wolf and Jim McPherson, both are talking about the previous, they are talking about where they have lived before, okay, and they are sharing about their like childhood, their happiness, their sadness, where they have experienced many times. So these things they are sharing to each other. Now thereafter, a Dorset. He smiled. I know this place. I know it very well. We shared my rum ration and his excellent sauces, and we talked. Connie, how we talked? He spoke almost perfect English, but it turned out that he had never set foot in Dorset. Never even been to England. He had learned all he knew of England from school and from reading books in English. Okay, so here is a matter that Hans Wolf is telling that Dorset, I know very well because I have been there sometime before, and I know very well how is this the city, and I have wandered there, and you know very well. Who is telling? Jim McPherson is telling to, Hans Wolf is telling to Jim McPherson that I have been in Dorset. Okay, and Jim McPherson was telling to his wife, about Hans Wolf that he had been in the Dorset, and he was speaking good English. Okay, but I know very well he never had been in the England. He is telling a lie because. I don't know why he is telling a lie, but he is telling a lie. Okay, but he knows very well English. He knows very well English. He is speaking too good English. So anybody can believe this thing that he is an Englishman, or he had been in England. Okay, how had he been learnt the English? He had been learnt English with reading English book, and to speak to those people who all are from the Englishmen. Okay. So while these things he know very well English, and according to these things he was telling to Jim McPherson that I had been England, in West England, in Dorset. Okay. His favorite writer was Thomas Hardy. Thomas Hardy is a great writer, but means was a great writer. Okay. So he always keep reading the book of Thomas Hardy. His favorite book, Far From the Madding Crowd. This is a book name, and it was a favorite book of, for whom? Hans Wolf. So, out there in no man's land, and we talked of Bathsheba and Gabriel Oak and Sergeant Troy and Dorset. Means, James McPherson is telling in writing a letter to his wife that we were talking about, means at that time we were talking about Bathsheba and Gabriel Oak and Sergeant Troy. So on these peoples, on these things they have talked so long time. Okay, then Hans Wolf told to Jim McPherson what he had a wife and one son born just 6 months ago. Okay, yani it's mean Hans Wolf, who is Hans Wolf? The German soldier, and German soldier is telling you to a British soldier, which whose name is this? Whose name is Jim McPherson. And Hans Wolf is telling to Jim McPherson, I have a wife and I have a lovely child. He is 6 months old. Okay. As I looked about me, there were huddles of khaki and grey everywhere, all over no man's land, smoking, laughing, talking, drinking, eating. Hans Wolf and I shared what was left of your wonderful Christmas cake, Connie. So all the people, means all the army soldiers were, who all were in the khaki dress, who all were in the grey coat dresses, they all are playing in the no man's land. They all were talking to each other. They all are sharing something, okay, to each other, and they are laughing, talking to each other, and drinking something, okay, and eating or thereafter Christmas cake. Okay, he thought of the marzipan was the best he had ever tasted. I agreed, and we agreed about everything, and he was my enemy. There never was a Christmas party like it, Connie. And Jim McPherson was telling to his wife, to Connie, that we have eaten marzipan cake, okay, and we have eaten all these things, like upside has been told, as sauces and some rations and some drinking wine types, okay. So both are agree to each other, and they had forgotten that they are enemy and they are against to each other. Think that how is possible, two enemies are sitting to get together, and they are talking about those families, their countries, their relations, and they are sharing to each other all these things, and they have forgotten one thing, that they all are enemies. Okay, but thereafter what happened? Then someone, I don't know who, brought out a football. Okay, great courts were dubbed in piles and make goal posts, and the next thing we knew, it was Tommy against Fritz out in the middle of no man's land. Jim McPherson is writing a letter to his wife, and he was telling that I don't know, but anybody brought a football to play there, okay, in this ground, in which ground, that is called no man's land. In that land they all came there, and they started to play the football. Okay, once again they are against to each other, means Tommy and Fritz. Okay, next, Hans Wolf and I looked on and cheered, clapping our hands and stamping our feet to keep out the cold as much as anything. There was a moment when I noticed our breaths mingling in the air between us, and he saw it too and smiled. Jim McPherson, he said after a while, I think this is how we should resolve this war, a football match. No one dies in the football match, no children are orphaned, no wives become widows. Means Jim McPherson was telling that the atmosphere has been changed. All the soldiers are playing, some soldiers are cheering up after sitting beside the field, okay, and both are sitting aside, and they are watching the match, and they are enjoying, they are happy, they are cheering up, they are stamping their feet, okay, they are enjoying this match. And the excellent message has been given by the writer to in this, and what was this? In this match, if anybody will win, so another party or another enemy, another soldier will lose, okay, but you know very well, here nobody will die in this match, in this battle, in this football match battle, nobody will die, no children will become orphan, no wives will become widows. That's a good message. Yes, if we need to fight, so there is no need to fight to our enemy. We can solve this matter while talking. Okay, so they have solved this matter while talking and while playing. Okay, I would prefer cricket.
I told him then we Tommies could be sure of winning properly. Okay, we laughed at that and together we watched the game. Sad to say, Conifers won 2-1. But as Hans Wolf generously said, our goal was wider than theirs, so it wasn't quite fair.
Okay, so here is a telling. Jim Everson belongs to British, and you know very well, British people like to play only cricket. They don't like to play football, and German people don't like to play cricket. Okay, if you will find anywhere a cricket team, so you did not find any German team in the cricket field. Okay, but British is very powerful team in the cricket field. Okay, so here it is. Jim McPherson tells, if I had to choose any game, so I choose what? Cricket. And I know very well my team can play good cricket. But and finally he Jim McPherson was sad to tell to her his wife, and he was telling that we lost 2-1, and Germans it means Fritz won the match. Okay, so Hans Wolf said, we know our goal and our winnings was so bright and wider also, but it's not only our win, it's your also, my dear. Who told? Hans Wolf told him, Jim McPherson. Okay, the time came, and all too soon. Okay, my dear students, I think we need to stop here, okay, and thereafter we will continue in the next video. Okay, thank you.